Hello friends, James here. In this video, we all examine Substance Painter, a program that is widely used in game making, car cater modeling, 3D animation, and CGI movies. Substance Painter, owned by Allegorithmic, a company acquired by Adobe, is an incredibly powerful 3D painting tool. It can be likened to a 3D version of Adobe Photoshop that you can use for digital painting. The main purpose of Substance Painter is to create texture models. Advanced masking and procedural texturing tools allow you to create textures that are much more difficult to achieve in purely 2D programs like Photoshop. Some examples include 8K texture baking, real-time PBR material workflows, and many material presets. With Substance Painter, painting can be done both on 2D maps and directly on the 3D model in the 3D viewport. This means you can see the edits in real time, so you know exactly what your texture will look like. Substance Painter displays and exports all textures in PBR format, so they can be imported directly into a game engine with the same result. To use Substance Painter, you need a polygonal 3D model. This 3D model is imported and used as the surface or object to be painted. So why use Substance Painter? Before Substance Painter came along, texture work was done with a combination of Photoshop and ZBrush, and it was necessary to switch between these two programs during the work. Substance has combined this workflow into a single program that significantly increases your workflow and speed. Quickly editing and creating textures for 3D models cannot be underestimated in terms of the importance of a 3D artist's workflow. This is why Substance Painter is a widely used piece of software in the gaming industry. Substance Painter is used in high-profile games such as Uncharted 4 and Horizon Zero Dawn, and is the choice of companies such as Capcom and Activision. The software allows 3A developers to quickly create realistic textures in a shorter time frame, allowing for faster game turnaround times and higher quality final meshes. Its widespread industrial use has also led to Allegorithmic becoming popular enough to be acquired by Adobe, who will continue the development and marketing of Substance Painter. Let's take a look at the Substance Painter interface and key features. The interface of Substance Painter will not be unfamiliar to those familiar with other 3D programs and the Photoshop interface. At the top is a standard toolbar. From there, you can access familiar drop-down menus from many other programs such as File and Edit. Let's look at the Substance Painter user interface. In the center, we see the 3D and 2D windows. The 2D window shows your texture as it appears on an unwrapped map after export. The 3D window shows your model as it will look after export. The toolbar below is where the Substance Painter tools are located, such as a brush for painting, an eraser for removing bugs or painting over parts you don't want, and numerous masking tools. Below this to the left, various other settings, are various other settings. These control your texture size and allow you to add additional base maps that you might want to paint over, and it also changes the settings in the renderer. With these, you can fine-tune it to be closer to your final scene so that your texture color is not distorted by lighting changes or other factors. There are also preset materials and textures in the interface that you can use on your models and edit to suit your aesthetic. On top of that, you will also find particle effects that can be used later to create effects on your model. At the top right, you have the Layers panel. Most of the behavior is the same as the layer tools in other programs, but if you have used Photoshop, this tool set will be familiar to you. Inside this panel is a drop-down menu that allows you to select individual attributes of the layer. 3D PBR textures have several map types, such as height and normals. This area of the user interface allows you to paint directly on individual maps, which is a very useful tool to have. Below this is the Properties panel. This is where most of your customization options are located. You can change brush sizes, colors, and how the various parts of the texture work. It's nice to play with all the settings and see what they do. Try it out and have fun with it. Now let's talk about advanced features and techniques. One of the most useful and powerful features of Substance Painter is the baking tools. In games, you're often limited by how high poly a model is. If a scene gets too dense, you start to lose performance. This is especially important on low-spec machines. Baking allows you to take a low-poly base mesh and create a second high-poly mesh using the base mesh as a template. When you have all the details you want in your high-poly mesh, you can then perform baking on the low-poly mesh. This means that Substance Painter will create a normal map for you. Normal maps are a type of map with a purple color that stores the lighting data in its vivid colors. When this map is applied to the low-poly mesh, the engineer or renderer will read the normal map and this will show how the light will react to the model. This can be used to make sharp edges look smooth or to add finer details that would require a higher poly count. Baking tools can usually be found in 3D software as standard. 3ds Max has one, for example. So what are the useful features of Substance Painter? One of the most fun features of Substance are the particle effect brushes. These can be used to create rain, cracks, or leaks on your models. This creates some hyper-realistic grunge effects when done right. The random nature of these procedural effects combined with the array of options means you will never get the same effect twice. Be careful when playing with these options. Turning the spawn rate of particle emitters too high can cause even high-end computers to struggle and cause some terrible software crashes. Finally, let's look at the Substance Painter masking tools. The last area we want to touch on is Substance Painter's excellent masking tools. Masking is very useful in editing and digital art as it allows you to protect certain parts of a texture from being edited. This is useful for painting patterns on a texture and making sure they don't spill where you want them to be. Substance Painter has several masking options. These include selecting individual polygons, selecting material IDs that you specify during modeling, selecting with solid colors, and the standard method of painting in your own masks. These all have their own uses and are very important to the overall workflow. There is a lot to tell about Substance, but I hope this video has given you a powerful overview of Substance Painter. If you haven't tried the program before, you can download and try Substance Painter, which is free for students and teachers, from the link in the video description. I hope this video has given you some insight into Substance Painter and what it does. Goodbye, and see you in my next video.